Hey everyone, Ben Walters here with the latest episode of Customer Tech Talks. I'm joined today by Parage and Huzefa from Icertis. Now, Icertis built their entire contract management solution from the ground up on Azure. But before we jump into the interview, let's take a look at their video.
With unmatched technology and category-defining innovation, Icertis pushes the boundaries of what's possible with contract lifecycle management. The AI-powered analyst-to-validator Icertis Contract Intelligence, or ICI platform, turns contracts from static documents into strategic advantages by structuring and linking the critical contract information that defines how an organization works. Today, the world's most iconic brands and disruptive innovators trust Icertis to fully realize the intent of their combined 7.5 million contracts spanning $1 trillion in more than 40 languages and 90 countries. ICI is built on and runs exclusively on Microsoft Azure and natively integrates with Microsoft cloud-based technologies, including Microsoft 365, Microsoft Dynamics 365, and Azure AI services. Icertis also offers business apps and experiences to surface the platform capabilities within other apps such as Salesforce. Icertis also provides data connectors to integrate with tools such as Adobe Sign and Mono.
So I'm joined here by Parage, and we've asked Huzefa to step out just for a moment, but he'll be back shortly. Parage, it would be great to hear how Icertis got started on this journey and how you got kind of kicked off this whole process of building this platform.
Yeah, absolutely. So we enjoy a 360-degree partnership with Microsoft. In fact, Microsoft was our first customer and strategic partner, and the engagement has only got stronger over a period of time with deep integration with Microsoft products. Icertis was born on Azure 10 years ago, and we continue to partner with Microsoft on key technologies to solve some of the complex contract management problems and scale and grow our ICI platform.
Now, as I understand, Icertis was built from the ground up on Azure. Can you take a moment to take us through some of the services you're using and how that's helping bring your platform the performance gains that you're getting?
So Icertis has been using several of the Azure services spanning across as fast, PaaS and SaaS to build its solutions, right from leveraging Azure Blob Storage, Azure Cache for Edge, to provisioning database using Azure SQL database. We've built our key solution components around Azure services. We've leveraged Azure serverless to scale our contract intelligence and give unparalleled performance to our customers.
Now, I can only imagine the type of storage that goes on behind a solution like this. And when we spoke earlier, you mentioned that you've been using Azure SQL database serverless for this. Can you talk a little bit about how you've used that and how you're continuing to grow that?
We started with Azure SQL database serverless, and we've expanded our serverless investments by using Azure Container Instances and functions to scale our applications. So, you know, one of the examples is we have a request for digitizing a million contracts across 25 data centers. Now, we've been able to do that using the serverless technologies.
So that sounds really interesting on the way you're scaling there. But before we go any further, are you able to maybe give us a quick demo of how the ICI platform works and how you can do this?
So currently have around 7.5 million contracts in our repository. And as we grow and add more customers to our ICI platform, the number of contracts is only going to increase. Now, one of the challenges that we have with our enterprise customers is that they want to digitize legacy contracts, which are in thousands. And this process takes them months. Now, one of the major areas which takes time is the OCR, the optical character recognition, that converts the PDFs into text files. Now, to solve this problem, we decided to go serverless, which will help us get the compute on demand and take away the overhead of infrastructure management. So let's take a scenario where a customer is expecting us to process or digitize 60,000 documents. Now, for that, we will be using bulk action from within ICI. So I go to ICI, I click on the bulk action tile. Here I see a list of the batches that have already been processed. Now, I've divided the 60K documents into three batches of 20,000 each. As you see, I've already processed two of these batches. Now I'll process a new batch. For that, I click on Add Actions. I have to key in two inputs. First, I have to put in the data file, which has a mapping between the attributes and the contracts. And second, I need to add the archive of the 20,000 documents. I give the batch a name and initiate the processing. Now let's head to the backend and see how this process is getting implemented using a new serverless approach. Now, the contract first gets broken down into pages. A fixed set of pages gets converted into jobs and waits for a container for it to be picked up. Now, we dynamically create these containers on the fly using Azure Container Instances. And each of these containers pick up the job and process it and terminate once there are no more jobs remaining for processing. So as you can see, this simplifies the entire process and can get scale on demand with absolutely no overhead of infrastructure management. After we do the digitization using OCR, we take the text through our machine learning algorithms to extract some key data points like obligations, clauses, metadata, and commitments. Now, Icertis offers some really good dashboards to surface this information and provide key insights to the customers in terms of the risk, the compliance, and the obligations. The clause deviation gives you details of the critical clauses which have deviated during the negotiations, and that can potentially impact the revenue. Now, the risk trends track risk across different categories, such as finance, contractuals, and performance throughout the entire contract lifecycle and increase the visibility for the stakeholders. The payment matrix shows how the terms have varied across for different suppliers and they help during the negotiations of the contracts. The obligation matrix show the distribution of fulfilled and unfulfilled obligations and provides a 360-degree view of obligations across the enterprise and contracts. The Icertis reports and dashboards are designed to provide crucial data to businesses so that they can cut down on their risk, reduce revenue leakage, and increase compliance.
So really, really great demo there. What I'm going to do now is I'm going to ask Huzefa to step in and give us a little bit more insight around how the solutions come together and what are some of the, I guess, higher impact portions of that processing that you had to deal with.
Yes, man. So OCR is a time-consuming operation. So if you have 20,000 documents with 50 pages each, we are really talking about a process which would take months. Even with parallelization with fixed compute, it will take weeks. So what we have done here is we have used Azure Durable Function fan-out fan-in strategy with a kind of Azure Container Instances to solve this thing. And this really helped us to bring down a time to few hours.
So really impressive to see the way that you've kind of pulled this together. Are you able to like step in and take us through a little bit more deeper of the architecture and how those components are working together to give you that performance?
Sure, man. So primarily, we are using three main components here. One is Azure Function, Azure Durable Function, and Azure Container Instances. So if you look into the architecture, an Azure Function is triggered each time a document is uploaded to a blob. The Azure Function then starts the orchestrator. So the orchestrator then calls another Azure Functions, which essentially breaks down this document into multiple jobs and pushes these jobs to a service bus, indicating that a job is ready. Then we have a watcher service running, which monitors the service bus and it creates a container on the fly. Each container then runs a job by picking up a message from a queue. It processes a job and also drops a completion message to a service bus. Each time a message gets dropped to a service bus, an Azure Function is triggered, which lets the orchestrator know that the job is completed. The orchestrator, once receives all completion messages, calls another Azure Function for concatenation of the results. The Azure Function also makes sure that it uploads the result back to the blob storage.
So really great to see how you brought all of that together. Now, I'm imagining with customers all around the world and 7.5 million contracts managed, that scale was probably a big consideration for you. Can you describe how you addressed that challenge and how you dealt with that when building the Icertis solution?
Right, Ben. So you're right. We serve diversified businesses which span across the globe. We deploy our solution to more than 25 plus Azure region to respect the data and privacy compliance for our customer. One of the challenges there was we had to make sure that the services are available across all these data centers. Second, you can imagine contracts are very sensitive information. So we had to make sure that this solution works seamlessly with Azure VNet and other networking and security services like Azure Key Vault. And third, we also had to take care of a startup time, which is an important consideration when you go serverless. We solved this using Azure Container Instances. It is highly configurable. In a sense, you can keep some containers running 24/7 and then elastically burst as and when the demand comes, as and when the load comes.
Gotcha. So really, really great kind of challenges addressed, not just on the scale, but also the security and also the speed for startup time, which is really interesting. Now, if I'm a customer out there who is looking to maybe build my own Azure global solution, what are some of the learnings or things you'd tell me to think about before I get started on my project?
So my recommendation is to start with a very structured POCs. And when you build serverless, think about things like startup times, performance, stateful management, and service availability, right? Another important consideration is to use loosely coupled components in your design and make sure your design is event-driven. And last but not the least, test before going into production to avoid last-minute surprises, because serverless takes a little bit getting used to.
Parage, Huzefa, thank you so much for joining us on Customer Tech Talks. And of course, if you want to learn more about the Icertis solution, you can head over to icertis.com for more information, or you can check them out on the Azure App Store as well. If you're looking for information on how to build your own scalable solution, check the links below for microsoft.com/learn and also docs.com for more information. And as always, we'll see you on the next Customer Tech Talks.